Hello, I'd like to introduce you to my automated nitrogen aquarium testing kit. Now, what this does is it tells you how much nitrate is in your aquarium water. Now, why do we care about this? Nitrate is a byproduct of the breakdown of fish waste, and it is, in high levels, very toxic to fish and is a common cause of death in aquariums. Now, how does this work? What we do here is we actually will sample a dose of aquarium water, determine the color of that aquarium water, and then from that color determine how much nitrate is in the water. Now, a very quick demonstration what this does. Right now, I'm substituting the commercial test kit that will be used in future models for standard colored water. Now, what we do, we take a sample. Okay, while we're waiting for this. Now, who would want this? Pet stores would be very interested in this because every day you in a pet store that sells fish, you have to test the water for nitrate. You have to keep a very close eye on it. Now, that gets tedious in large aquarium settings because you have multiple tanks, you have to do it over and over. This, though, can, on a regular basis, tell you very easily through these two LEDs that tell you based on a threshold, do you have too much nitrate in your water and do you need to take action? This can tell you if action is necessary without user input. All you have to do, press a button, or it can, in future models, be set to operate on a timed schedule. Now we have determined our nitrate level here. We've determined that it is 208 parts per million, which is very high and unacceptable. Thus, the system, through this red LED, is giving the user a graphic warning that there is too much nitrate in the water and that action is required. We're now flushing the system to set up for the next test. This would also be useful to home aquarium users who, in large aquariums that require lots of maintenance, or for people that don't have the time every day in order to actually take care of their aquarium as they'd like to. This lets them still keep track of what's going on. Now, the system is now ready for another reading, and we can give it something that we know will be safe. This is a much lower nitrate level. And if I just hold that in there. And we're ready to go. Now, what else needs to be done for this? Now, obviously, you can see that we aren't actually dosing anything to actually use the commercially available nitrate test kits. And what will be done in the future is we will add a second dose, two more dosing pumps in order to actually dose this, and we will then have direct nitrate readings. Now we take 30 readings in order to get a good average of our nitrate level with the color sensor in order to help eliminate some of the errors. We're just about ready. And you can see that this is for some that might be considered high, but for most aquariums, 12 parts per million is well within tolerable range. And you can see our graphic has told us that we're good to go. And once again, we're flushing the system. All right, thank you very much. I appreciate your time.
Go for it.
All right, so discussing the hardware we've got going on here, what we have here is we have a little peristaltic pump that's meant for dosing. It's very good for very small, very precise dosing, and it also is low maintenance because it's never in direct contact with the fluid. Bring it up through here. Okay. Then what we've got here is we've got a little $7 RGB color sensor just off of Adafruit. Cheap little thing, and it just gives you RGB values and also clarity, Kelvin. It can give you a lot of information, and it has a built-in LED for it to determine what color things are. Now, what we're doing to get the color right now, we have these syringes here. Each of these syringes, because it is a binary test kit, these standard aquarium nitrate test kits,
What we do is we first would dose the first chemical mix back here. We have the, some little vibrator motors that help mix the fluid. Then we
dose. You see those ripping real fast?
They're not hooked up right now, but they're just little. These are what you'd find in your cell phone.
Okay, so this clear chamber is the mixing chamber.
Yes.
So fresh water.
Fresh aquarium water comes in through here.
One sec.
Guys, can we just, one second before we, can we?
Okay, so fresh water comes in through here?
Yes.
Right, from the aquarium.
From the aquarium, yes.
Comes into your mixing chamber.
Mm-hmm.
And then once it's in the mixing chamber, the chemicals
are dosed. Right now we have, right now we've got syringes, but in the future we would have their own separate dosing pumps in order to automate the process. Right now this is kind of just one shot and it's done. Dosing pumps would allow us to have multiple shots. Now, we've also, as we already discussed, we've got the sensor there that tells you what color it is, which is how these test kits work. You just compare it to this color chart and that tells you how much nitrate's in your water. Up here we've got a solenoid, little tiny 12-volt DC solenoid. This just gives us a nice seal and makes sure that the chamber is isolated so we don't end up having backflow, things like that. We then, when we're taking a sample, we open the solenoid to allow it, so this doesn't turn into a pressure vessel. Then when we're ready to, also same thing, just whenever we're moving water with the pump, we have the solenoid open, when we close it, we've got a sealed system.
Awesome.